Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sneha Shetty, Clinical Director, Chief Fertility Specialist at Vriksh Fertility, HSR Layout, Bengaluru. Follicular monitoring is a very important procedure which is used to evaluate and to manage infertility. So it involves closely monitoring the development and growth of the follicles in the ovary, which usually contains the egg, thereby tracking the follicular growth throughout the menstrual phase of a woman. So this helps us understand whether the follicle is growing or not, whether the follicle is rupturing, which we call as ovulation, which will tell us the exact time period when to have intercourse in order to have very high chances for pregnancy. Also, it gives us an insight with regards to the uterus lining, wherein the embryo which forms will have to come and sit. So we also understand how the uterus and the ovaries are in the same time. So why is follicular monitoring done? There are various reasons why your doctor would recommend you to do follicular monitoring or follicular tracking in ultrasound. One is to actually track your ovulation time. So by assessing the growth of the follicles, we come to know when exactly is your ovulation time, which is much more reliable and gives us an exact information whether ovulation has occurred or not, and what is the timing during which, if you have intercourse, your chances are higher. Number two is to understand whether the medications which we are giving for the follicular growth, if they are working properly or not, especially in treatments like IUI, intrauterine insemination, or in IVF, wherein the response to the medications given has to be monitored, and accordingly we can change the medications depending on the follicular size. Number three, it gives us an insight with regards to the egg quality. If the follicle is growing well, the size and the growth of it, the blood flow around the follicle, gives us an idea whether there is a mature egg which is going to be present inside the follicle or not. Number four, it also helps us in detecting certain potential problems which could be there, like irregular ovulation. Either the ovulation sometimes happens quite early or quite late, or in conditions like anovulation, in polycystic ovarian syndrome or polycystic ovarian disease, and also helps us diagnose certain conditions or certain ovarian cysts like endometriotic cysts or other complex cysts.